interested in this particular pin on the baseball, right? So by looking at the schematic, you will see this is a pin on the microprocessor connected to this baseball pin. Okay? And remember, what should we do for the GPIO? You all remember that? This part. Right? What does this do? We are initializing the particular pin, right? To a certain function, right? Function zero, because function zero is the GPIO mode, right? And second step, we need to decide whether it's an input or output, right? So in this case, same thing, but if you look at the files, some header files given, okay, if you check this side, you have three libraries here, right? And then you can find some functions from this baseball library, okay? So that's, you can see the list of the function first from the .h file, okay? So if I, this is RGB, right? If I open it, I can see there are two functions given for the RGB, okay? How these two are defined, then you can go to the RGB.c or you press F3, then you go to this file, okay? So here you have RGB initialization and RGB set LEDs. These are the two functions given, okay? So for this case, the RGB, right? From the previous lab, right, we need to firstly set the pin to function zero, right? Then set the direction. This time, you don't need to manually key in because the RGB initialization, this function, does the initialization for you, okay? You may realize that we don't have this for that particular file, but in this case, it doesn't matter because that file, that particular pin, by default, is function zero. Okay, so if you see the... the user guide... is a user manual for the microprocessor. Remember, you use this actually for the... Okay. See here? Okay. Which pin we are interested in? Pin 2.0, right? So port 2, pin 0. Function when 00 is GPIO, right? And the reset value 00 means the default value is 00. If you don't key in this one, it's fine. By default, it's 0. Okay? That's why the RGB initialization just skip step 1. Okay? It just does step 2, sets the direction. Okay? Which means in your main program, you can just call this function to do the initialization. Okay? And then this is a function to set the color. Okay? So later on, whatever devices we are dealing with, there are always some functions, one function or several functions to do the initialization, and some functions that for you to use it. Okay? Use the device. Okay, so if you look at this function carefully. Remember, our task is to set that particular LED to different colors, right? Because we have three options. So you can see this. Basically, the LED mask will tell the function what color you want to turn on. Okay? I mean, after you set the hardware properly. Okay? You can see the description and the meaning of the parameter here. Okay? It set the LED states. So LED mask is used to turn LEDs on or off. Okay? For example, if you don't know what value you need to put in here to turn on red, for example. Okay, you look into the function, you see, you have three if-else loop. Basically, they are checking. They are checking whether which color you want to turn on, right? If it's red, you end with red. What does this mean? This is a predefined constant. Okay, if you press F3, this is the definition. You see, if the number is this, it will be red. Okay, if the number is 2, it will be blue. Okay, imagine if my LED mask is 1. Okay, if my LED mask is the same as my RGB red. If I add this 2, what should I get? If I add something with itself,
red.
You will get that particular number, right? Oh, this is this bitwise? It's not bitwise, right?
It is bitwise.
It's bitwise. Anyway, if this one is equal to this one, you won't get 0. See, then you go into this loop, right? In your library, it will be like this. If you import your library, you will see that your RGB.file will be like this. Firstly, here is 0. This is wrong. Why? Remember how our GPIO underscore set direction works? What's the meaning of the first parameter?
Hot
number. Right? Second, look at this. It's a bit value, right? Is a bit value you want to set to that particular position. Right? And 1 is the direction. Right? So here, if I write 0, is it correct? What I want to do is I want to set pop 0 has 32 bit, right? I want to set this one to be what? What value? I mean, this pop 2. I want to use this, right? What value should I set here? Look at this one. Look what you did here.
Zero.
Sorry, this one. You did this, right? For the push button, right? So this one means, what does this mark? This one mean? You shift 1 by 31 times, right? Then the 1 will go to somewhere here, right? That means this bit you want to set to 1, right? So in this case, rather than write that this way, I should write somewhere something like this, right? Because I don't want to shift, but I want 1 to be here, right? I'm setting P2.0.
just one.
Yeah, so that's why you write one. You write one here, okay? So later I'll make sure you correct this call. Okay, there are errors in this RGB loss C. Okay, so here should be one. Same thing here. You see RGB set value. If you look at the definition, top number, bit value. C is the same as the GPIO set direction. Okay? That's why here is also wrong. You need to change it to 1. Okay? You get what I mean? Why you need to change this? Okay, so once you change this header file, later on, you need to build all projects, okay, before you debug your main function, okay, because you made a change, you made changes on in the library files, okay. So this one actually concludes the things I mentioned. Okay? So firstly, you know which pin you need to control. Okay? And then in the RGB.h, you have two functions. This one is to do the initialization. Okay? To do the GPIO initialization, actually. The RGB set LED, this LED mask, you can just simply give the name. These are the global constant you can use. Okay? And these are the errors you need to correct in your header file. Okay? And I know some of you still keep the demo program, the speakers. Okay? So later on when you try this RGB, you better comment your play song. Okay, why? Because if you check your schematic carefully, you will see that the pins here, okay? I mean, there are three pins for the RGB, right? So some other devices are also use the pins here. I mean, some devices sharing the same pin, okay? So if you try to play the song and as well as turn on the LED, you may have some problem. Means, so for example, you are controlling your LED correctly, but your speaker also take the signal from that particular pin, then your speaker may play some like a strange song. Okay? So, you know what to do, right? If I say, just push. For example, my task is to push SW. Let's push SW4 to turn on red LED. Okay? You have an idea how to do this? Okay? Then maybe I give you 20 minutes, okay, to try this. So try to read the RGB.h and RGB.c to see how to use these two functions. Okay.